Buzz Lightyear to Star Command. Come in, Star Command.
Hey guys and gals, I'm here with a video. Today, I'll be looking at the Lightyear Hyperspeed Series Armadillo, which is a Target exclusive. I will have a link to Target's page for it. You can probably find it in retail. My Targets don't have them, but Target.com does. And I'm just going to cut to the chase. Out of all the ships I have from the Hyperspeed Series, this is the first one where I'm like, I'm not wooed, and it's solely because of the price. I like the overall design of the ship. It's a good little drop ship. It's got some nice little features here and there, and I'll get to its accessories in a second, but this thing is $25. If you remember, when I covered this guy, the Zurg fighter, this, at least at the time of making this video, this is $21 through Amazon. I may have gotten mine for $25, I don't remember. But the fact that these two are the same price is really, really sad. It is. And just for a further comparison, here is the XL-15. So you can just see how these guys all look together. I'm not going to bring out all the other XL ships. I feel like we're going to see this one and these two together in the movie. So $12 for this, depending on where you get it. $21 on Amazon. Entertainment Earth has it for like $40-something. I don't know if Amazon has it as a pricing error or what, because $25 or $21 is a fantastic deal. The sculpting on this, the paintwork, the plastic, everything looks hunky-dory. It looks great. It looks fantastic. Pick whatever adjective you want. That's positive. Let me go ahead and take these guys away. This, however, it's one solid chunk of plastic. You have very little paint detailings on the little vents there, little stripes. So you have the number 2 and the Star Command logo down there. But then there's nothing else over here. Like, you have the sticker for Zap Patrol, which is part of the, I guess, subsections of Star Command. The planet they're trapped on has a bunch of bugs, so they got a Zap Patrol, whatever. I like that sticker, but I wish there was one on this side as well. And they also have these little stickers on the side, which I get what they were trying to do, but the stickers don't fit very well. They're kind of popping off. You can see some of the paint is already chipping off, or paint, sticker residue, whatever they use for stickers. It's already coming off, and it was like that when I got it. I'm wishing this had been like a proper decal, or just, was it like a tampon? I don't know. It would have looked so much better just having that be a little more flush with all this little detailing. I'm very tempted to pull that off and try to repaint it myself. I don't know. But with this being this solid brown, I wish there was more detailing. You know, the hatch up there, the little bits down there, if there was more paint application, this would have felt a lot better. As it is, $25, I'm not feeling it. If you do want to see its packaging, really quick, it's in the same kind of one as Zurg's fighter. If you want to see my video of those guys, it's up there. It's a Hyperbeast series. I'm calling them Series 1. Are they Series 1? I don't know. So the accessories for this guy, and I will get to its features as well. You got a missile launcher. You got an extra missile. You got a Mr. Lightyear. We're going to put him right there. He ain't going to stand. Ooh, there's a long hair. And we got Izzy. Now, one thing I will say, and I'll see if the Target still has the picture. The stock art they have for Izzy looks terrible. And maybe it's just because you're zoomed in on it. I feel like mine, while yes, it's still a little dopey, I will give you that. But for its size, I feel like this looks a lot better in hand than the stock art they have does. Izzy is in her Junior Zap Patrol armor. She is the granddaughter of Buzz's friend, Alicia, which you can't see Buzz. So we're going to see how that works out. Like the other pilots, she has arm articulation. They can rotate. The legs can go forward. They can go back. I really feel like for a figure this size, I feel like it's detailed pretty well. I'm not really upset. I'm glad we have another character besides Buzz. Speaking of Buzz, we do get another Buzz. And I'm really disappointed that it's just a slight repaint. It's a reuse of the XL-15 Buzz. You can see the XL-15 has a kind of more of a blue kind of hue for his dome or his helmet. Whereas this one kind of looks more pearly. The white on this feels like it's a lot brighter. I'm not sure that's coming through on camera or not. This one is a little more yellowed. But you can see the paint's a little rough on this one. But I feel like this would have been a great opportunity to give us a Buzz without his helmet on, without his visor. We've got Izzy without her helmet. Assuming she has a helmet, I don't even know. But I would have loved to have had a Buzz that doesn't have the helmet. But, you know, being like this, you could pretend this is Buzz and another Space Ranger. If you wanted, that's totally up to you. But that's how those two look together. There's the back. So, yeah. There we go. Of course, the cockpit does open up. And it clicks in there. And you can fit both your pilots inside. Izzy goes right in the front. Buzz, you got to kind of wiggle him a little bit. Mine tends to get stuck. And they just fit inside like that. Now, one stupid complaint I have, like, if you're a kid, you're going to be And if you want to get to your little pilots, you know, they're not really secure that well. Is that a dumb complaint? Most likely. I feel like it's valid if you're a kid, though. Maybe not. This does have movable wings, fins, whatever you want to call it. I believe the official position is meant to be down like this. These guys kind of move too, but not really enough to really justify it. But, yeah, there's something. And you do, of course, have the landing gears. Those can clip up if you do not want them down. For the purposes of this video, we're going to leave them down. We're not doing any kind of high flying today, so we can just put that down. And now we get to the missile launcher. I'm removing hair from all of this because, yeah, I have cats. The missile launcher itself is fine. I do like it. However, I wish there was more options to use it. As it is, your only option is to take down the hatch, and then you're going to peg it right inside here. And I got to say, like, it's a minor thing, but I like that so much it goes inside. It does feel like it is part of the ship. And if you wanted, you could have... They're not going to stand very well, but you could have a character, you know, manning the gun, if that's what you're into. So, like, I do like that. I mean, that's a nice feature. However, when it comes to storing it, there's no other place to put it. These are the locking connectors that hold it into the packaging. You will have to twist those out to pull it out. And I thought these little holes would have been places you could mount the gun, but the peg does not fit unless I want to force it way too hard and potentially make it where it's not going to fit in this anymore. So if you don't want to have the gun out, you're basically stuck with just chucking it in the back. And I wish there was a better way. I wish you could mount it on the back or on top of the ship somewhere, maybe on the bottom, just something, because it just... Is that a dumb nitpick? Like, am I just complaining for the sake of complaining? I don't think so. I feel like that's a valid complaint. I've been spoiled by Transformers that have weapons you can store away. So, of course, the missile does fire. It's got a little push button. We're going to see how well it does fire. Sorry, Izzy. You're going to have to take one for the team. I lied. There's Zurg. We're going to leave Izzy there, though. And we'll just give a nice little... Well, that was something. We're going to try this again. There we go. We took out both of them. It's got a really good spring in it. I do like it. And one added feature that these have, let me kill my lights. Boop and boop. These are actually glow-in-the-dark missiles. So if you get them all charged up, that's kind of fun. I don't think they hold a charge very long. So like by the time you're charging them up, you better fire them right away. So let me, you know what, we're gonna try this. Let me go ahead and get this guy all charged up. I have not really tried this myself to see how long it does hold a charge. I feel like it fades really quickly. I'm going to put that in there and then get Zurg back up before it's too late. And then, well, lost the missile. But we got Zurg. Also, the front of the ship, those little stickers, are also glow in the dark. I'm not really sure why, of all things, you would give it glow in the dark teeth. You know, that kind of detail, but it's there. I don't really know why. If that was the only justification for having the stickers, I would have preferred if they were just painted details. I don't really need the whole glow in the dark stuff. And I guess that's really ultimately all that I can say for this. Are those guys fully down? Yeah, they are. They're down. I like the ship itself. I do. Like, it's nice to have something different. You know, we can't keep getting XL whatever ships, even though there's like four more coming. I've seen there's the XL3, there's the XL, I want to say the 9, 12, and 14 that are coming out. We've seen Zurg's mothership that I have on the way to me. So, like, it's good to have other ships, but, you know, thinking in retrospect, there are other members of Zap Patrol. So I don't know why they gave us another Buzz. At least we have Izzy, at least we have some variety among our Star Command pilots, but it is still annoying to me, at least, that we have so many Buzzes, and I really don't think they're going to make more ships with the rest of the cast. I'll be very surprised. I feel like the Armadillo would have been a great chance to give us two additional characters instead of just Buzz and Izzy. But who knows? The movie might come out and we won't like any of the characters. I don't know. Ultimately, this isn't a bad ship. I feel like if this was $5 cheaper, if this had been $20, if it had been $18, $17, kind of in that ballpark, it would have been way more worth it. For $25, which maybe that's just Target's markup over what this would have been elsewhere, I really don't know. But there should have been more in there. There's been more detail. There should have been more stickers. They should have done a lot better job with the teeth. The fact that we have one Zap Patrol sticker and the other side doesn't have it, it just feels lazy. Yes, we've got a decent missile launcher. No, you cannot peg these onto the XL ships. The ports are totally different, in case you were wondering. But you should have gotten more. This is one of the hyperspeed ships. I would say maybe pass, unless you wind up really liking it in the movie, or you're a completionist, or you find this on sale at some point. For $25, you can do so much better. I mean, you can get Zurg's fighter for $20, and that's kind of my benchmark for these. The XL ships being $12, fantastic. Zurg's fighter being $21, $25, good, great, Googa Mooga, great deal. $25 for this is just really disappointing. It is. But that is it for this video, guys and gals. I hope you have enjoyed it somewhat. Thank you for sticking around if you've made it this far, and I will see you around. Take care.